is a dial that controls us today. In our present times, politics seems to be the current title that instantly makes us bow down and worship. Somehow the melody, the sounds, the rhythms of this song mesmerizes us, disease hooks us in, and we believe the false narrative. Politics will save the day. Politics will bring about justice and equity. And we naively give over our allegiance to a political party, an ideology, or somehow we begin to unrecognize or not admit the injustices embedded within each political party, the inconsistencies of each politician. And I pause here for a moment to recognize that for some of us, the word politics is an ugly word. And for others, politics is a word that should stay out of the church. However, consider this for a moment. The word politics derives from the Greek word politikos, which refers to the shared life of citizens, to the arrangement of human common life together. From that perspective, politics should become a good word. In fact, I will submit to you that politics should become a sacred and holy word because it refers to the beautiful, God-given human life that we share with one another. It points out to the mutual call of how humans share with each. This morning, I would love to reclaim that word in this room. In all its beauty, in all its messiness and sacredness. And perhaps you have heard someone say, I'm not political. Or you've heard someone say, I don't like talking about politics. But in my opinion, that framework of thinking is misguided. I wonder, did your religious teacher come this morning? I wonder, did you use water to take a shower or brush your teeth? Did you eat breakfast? Did you take a road or a highway to get here? If so, then you are being super political. Somehow, somewhere, at some point in history, someone ran a campaign, was elected, and voted into the position so to make political decisions how to get water, electricity, food, and roads to your neighborhood. Politics seem to be everywhere. Affecting how we arrange our common life together. Naturally, Jesus was political. In his time on earth, he spent time reclaiming political things, reinterpreting cultural, religious, ethnic, and gender-based politics. He ate with tax collectors, he touched the lepers, he sat with prostitutes. Those two were all political statements. Jesus was sentenced to death on a cross by Pontius Pilate, a political leader, by the way, a Roman governor. The cross, which was a political first century Roman symbol of humiliation, of suffering, of pain, and death, and it was reclaimed. Jesus snatched the cross, this political symbol of oppression, and reclaimed it as a symbol of liberation. This is why I love today's wisdom. It is so lovely, it is so poetic, for it reclaims how to be human. At its core, the wisdom shows us how to be unhooked from other things. So let's address it, let's confront it for a moment. Our American society is constantly, and I mean constantly, offering us false narratives of how to be human. Have you noticed? Telling us what to say and how to be, what to do and how to think. Bombarding us with distorted narratives, and we reluctantly and sometimes willingly conform to such falsehoods. However, in this parable of the 99 never loved sheep and the missing one, Jesus presents a sound, an organic, a natural version of how to be human. What should the shepherd do? Should the shepherd leave behind the 99 in the hot and weary desert Or should the shepherd go after the missing one? I can tell you what our American culture would say. Forget the missing one. You already have 99 others. Take care of your assets because you may lose them all. Get your boxes. It would be a waste of time, money, and energy going after the missing one. Think about yourself. You matter more than the missing one. Such a false narrative. And yet, many sing this song in our society. Still, Jesus, oh Jesus, offers a better version of being human. He advocates for the shepherd to leave the 99 for the lost one. Because every sheep is inherently bad. And when the lost sheep is found, we have to be very joyful, carry the sheep on your shoulders, and when you get home, celebrate, have a big old party. For the lost has been found. Can you distinguish between the oppressive narrative from the liberating narrative? Can you distinguish the hooked life from the unhooked life? Can you distinguish the song of truth from the song of deceit? One song sings the praises of compassion, love, dignity, and value, and the other song blatantly opposes the Jesus. Perhaps we too have become blinded by the false narratives of our human society. Living out of fear and scarcity, believing this whole system is rigged, so why should I even participate? Believing this system doesn't benefit us. That's you. I see you and I hear you. Not sure who needs to hear this, but you must know that the divine is for you and not against you. That your benefit can only truly be found in the Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer that you struggle. Jesus, the good shepherd, will lead the 99 and chase after you. So be encouraged, be hopeful, for the universe to be with you. And I remind you that the future of this whole thing is not less engagement, it is not less participation or less voting. It's not that. Rather, it will take more well-informed people to call out the injustices in politics and politicians and their policies. See, this whole thing is not merely about beliefs and thoughts. It's not merely about the issues we agree with or don't agree with. Ultimately, this whole thing requires action, validity, credibility, authenticity. This is the same question that is being raised against the church, my friends. Where is the credibility of the church? Where is the authenticity of the church? The church should be a manifestation of the credibility of God. This is one of the primary reasons why people have stopped attending churches. But do you want to know the scandal of it all? See, the scandal of it all is how Christians have discredited the God of the scriptures for generations. How we have discredited the name of Jesus, the reputation of the church, and it's even happening right now, this day, in this political season, dragging the name of God, the church, the Bible, through the blood of sin and shame, used to perpetuate sinful fears of homophobia, transphobia, and xenophobia, and sexism, and white supremacy, just to mention a few. It is devastating to be the church right now, I hear you. You no longer have any credibility. No moral or spiritual soundness. No justice or compassionate reliability. No racial or social integrity. Painting. Say such things. It's ultimately not part of the church. My ancestors were part of that church. It's not merely just about self, about my rights, my beliefs, but Jesus makes the point it is about many others in living a liberated life as well. The 99 sheep found you, without a doubt, to be with the people. And at the end of the day, if it ever is true to me, that that shepherd will always come for me. That is the beauty of this. That our greatest hope lies in our ability to identify ourselves. Can you identify yourself? One true song and melody that has its driving baseline and the evidence for this tight drum beats and groove that God gives us. You see, the song is not a quiet, beginner, and invisible song. But instead, it's a song that plays loud for all to hear, that plays out in real time, in real places, where political power is most abusive and most violent. See, I see that hope when God moves in us to think, to live, to respond and act like God through Jesus. And with a value and dignity, every person is uplifted, hope is near. When one soul is liberated from political oppression, hope is near. When the students of Jesus come as close as possible to the core of the divine flow, reclaiming credibility among the world. And when the Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer become priority above all else, then the reclaiming of our way of being human, the reclaiming of goodness and sacredness in all politics, and the reclaiming of this enhanced common shared life together will come. Word of God and Word of life, we all sit together.